All right, 3, 2, 1. We are joined today by Dominican head coach Janine Zippery and senior Christina Wilson and senior Caitlin Foote. Coach, can you start us off with an opening statement on today's match?
I don't think that we came out doing what we needed to do to win. We're a great team. We just didn't do the little things that we needed to do to win. And props to Illinois Wesleyan, they did. So I think that that's really what it is. We can compete against them. We just didn't do what we needed to compete today.
Can you talk about your season in review? It's always nice to make it to the national tournament, but can you talk about the season in review?
I think that this year we've made a lot of strides as a program. This is only my second year with the group, and we've, included a new defensive system that, I'm trying to get the kids to buy into. We had a big hitter go out middle of the season, which definitely, took some time to adjust. Moving some kids around, had a lot of depth, but we won some big matches. We competed. We're a lot tougher mentally against some teams that normally we don't really compete well against. So I think we're moving in the right direction as a program. 23-10 is a pretty good year. You got to feel good about that, but nobody ever feels good ending on a loss like this. So
can you talk a little bit about your seniors?
Oh gosh. I mean, what can I not say about them? I'll start with Olivia, who's not here. Kid came to me her junior year, said, "Coach, I have an identity crisis. I don't know what position to play. I don't know what the team needs from me." And I said, "Let's focus on defense." Last year she battled for the libero jersey. This year she kept Caitlin on her toes for the libero jersey. It was offensive out of the back row. Really bought in, really cleaned everything up. Great kid, really great kid. And then we've got Caitlin here who had a career night in our conference championship match with 40 digs in the match. Moved her from a 3-year starting outside hitter to our libero this year. So, taking a new role because that's what the team needed and not even questioning it, came into preseason, "Okay, what do you need from me, coach?" You can't ask for that, and kid just does unbelievable things defensively. And then we've got Christina, who became our school's career assist leader. Up until this weekend, she was first in the nation with total assists. So coming from our school, we were struggling a little bit offensively. To still have that achievement is something that she needs to be proud of. I think our leadership this year was a lot stronger and was what we needed to move more in the right direction. So.
Christine, can you talk about what it means to you to be able to play for this Dominican program?
It's incredible. I mean, not too long before we came, it was a completely different program. And to see how we've changed throughout the years, and even from my time as a freshman to now, we've just transformed entirely. And it's just been an amazing ride. And I really couldn't have asked for a better experience.
Same question to you, Caitlin.
Same exact thing. I mean, it could not have been a better experience. We took a team that was 0-30-something, and throughout our 4 years, we've been to the national tournament every single year, and that is a huge accomplishment. And we talked about this in the locker room. We're only going to get better from here. We know what we need to do. We talk about the little things, and we know that's what's going to get us there. And I look forward to watching these girls in the next few years. They're going to do great things.
Yeah, the three seniors set an example, set a precedent, are leaving a legacy, and they have set the tone, and now it's up to us to kind of keep moving forward.
Coach, can you talk about the team's never die mentality? It seems that you kept pushing back when your backs were against the wall.
That's something that this team definitely had a lot of this year. We've had a lot of practices where we did drills that had blue in the lips at the end of it, where they're going until they are literally a little bit blue in the lips. They're laying out for balls. We have our 5 burpee rule, or you hear the word can't, everybody in the gym's got 5 burpees. If anybody makes an excuse, we've got 5 burpees. So I think it's just changing your mentality, to just go and to not give up and to believe that you can. Even if you fail, you keep believing that you can keep touching those balls and getting the kill and getting the big serve at the end of the match. So we've definitely grown as a program. The mentality has switched. It's just the culture where I inherited a great culture and now I'm trying to strengthen it. So,
anything else, sir?
I think we should be good.
Thank you very much.